Real people's armpits will not be seen at this time in order that we may bring you the following disjointed program.
You know, Karen, I was just thinking.
You were?
Yeah, I was thinking about
those parts of the body that you don't use when you donate your body to science. You know, like your toenails and your appendix and your stomach and your lungs and your shin bones. All those really ugly parts. What do they do with those when you donate your body to science?
Do that. What seems to be the problem, Lisa?
You see, I'm different from everybody else.
You can say that again.
I'm different from everybody else. You see, I don't have the same parts that everybody else has. You see, I've got parts that other people don't have, and they have parts that I don't have.
When did you first notice this, Lisa?
Oh, when I was changing after gym class.
Well, this will be very easy to fix. I'm going to write you out a prescription here.
Oh, for medicine?
No, it's for your English teacher. To teach you how to read. Been going into the boys' locker room. Oh, that's $50, please.
Hi, and welcome to an interesting episode, if you can. Okay, let's be honest here. This is going to be a pretty
boring episode if you can't do that on television. Because this show is about body parts. And they won't let me talk about the parts of the body that I want to talk about. Because I think that...
Cut.
See what I mean?
I have some good news, Christine, and I have some bad news. Which would you like first?
Ross, I'm trying to do my introduction here.
The good news is that the producer is looking for the perfect body to play a part in a national commercial. There's a lot of money involved here. Nationwide exposure. Big boost to anybody's career.
Great. Hollywood, here I come.
The bad news is you're not it.
Oh.
Now, I think I should point out, though, Christine, in all honesty, to me, you will always be a perfect 10.
Oh. Thank you, Ross. I didn't really know you cared.
Mind you, you should also remember that that's sort of 100.
Yes?
Hi. We're on a spare body parts drive, and we want to know if you have anything to donate.
Oh, well, yes, I do.
A complete set.
Valerie, what are you doing?
Sir, what do you think is the most important part of the body?
The ear.
The ear? Come on, gotta be kidding.
I'm not kidding, Alistair. When I teach you, it goes in one ear and out the other. Which means I can grab the ear and direct you to the principal's
house. Come on, sir!
Wait around.
It's the producer.
We're
looking for...
It's the producers are looking for the perfect body. It's gotta be a girl they're looking for.
Why?
Because they've already got two perfect boys in the show.
Where?
Ready? Hey!
Wait! Stop there, Susan!
What is it?
Well, you see, I plan to donate my body to science, and what good would it be if it was all shot up, and I'd have to give the money back.
I think we've got a problem here, amigos. It looks like we're going to have to cancel your execution.
Oh, great.
And drown you instead. There's a beautiful lake, yeah, just over the hill. And what we do is we take you and we push you under the water, but we tie a rope to your legs so we don't lose you, because we think science is important too, right, amigos? Yeah, come on, let's go.
Mom, what was it that first attracted you to Dad?
Oh, well, Lisa, I guess it was his great big brown eyes.
But, Mom, Dad has blue eyes.
You know, you're right. He does. I think I'm in the wrong house. Well, it's been very nice meeting you.
You know, Alistair, I'd give my right arm to get out of this place.
You would?
Well, yeah, the rotten food, the enforced labor, the constant torture the black flies buzzing about. My right arm would be a small price to pay to get out of this dump.
Then maybe we have a chance.
What?
With your right arm for them to chew on, we can run past the dogs. Come on!
Lisa, have you ever thought how weird it is that people like to eat things like pig's knuckles and calves' brains and tongue? Oh, that really grosses me out.
Why? You eat steak or chicken or eggs, which are future chickens. I mean, it's all protein, so why does it matter where it comes from?
Yeah, I never really thought of it that way. I guess you could be right.
Yeah, hungry?
Oh, sure.
Oh, my.
That's really good, what is it?
I'm chocolate-covered grasshoppers. It is all protein.
Alistair, how do you like the new stick-on patches I got for your knees, dear?
They're great, Mom, except I'd like it better if I wasn't wearing shorts.
Just be thankful they're not the kind I have to sew on. Now, the glue is guaranteed forever, so get ready for school.
But, Mom, can I wear long pants?
No.
You know, Christine, I think for the producer to say that you are not perfect for that national commercial is absolutely stupid.
Oh, really, Ross?
Yeah. In fact, I think you're probably the most perfect type for that hostess. I mean, look at you. You're pretty, you're sweet, you're smart. Everything that a producer could probably want. I don't know why they're looking elsewhere for somebody.
Well, thanks, Ross. I didn't know you cared.
I don't. Oh, this is an introduction for the opposite sketches.
Oh, Karen, I was going to ask you before, do you happen to have a cat?
Why do you ask? Oh, it's okay, Karen. This is an opposite sketch.
That's right. You see, I got all these parts left over, and it's all good stuff. This is, look, there's the kidneys, heart, and liver, all pure beef parts. Now, I wouldn't want to put them into my burger mixture, so I thought if you had a cat, why, you'd like to take him home, these goodies.
Christine, what's that you're putting on your nails?
Oh, it's just this nail polish that stops you from biting them.
That's just what I thought. I want you to stop that this instant and go upstairs and wash it off. You know how much you enjoy biting your nails.
Mom, it's a disgusting habit.
Well, yes, I know, Christine, but it just makes you so happy.
Aw, Dad.
Ah, your mother has a point there, Christine.
Oh, that's right. Now, upstairs. We want you happy. Happy! Happy!
Oh, this is your funny bone. And when you hit it, it makes you laugh. Now, the writers for this show request that everyone out there hit their funny bone because they figure it's the only way they're going to get a laugh from this rotten material. And I agree.
Dad?
Mm-hmm?
Why do you love Mom?
Why do I love your mother? I'll tell you, because that's easy. Beneath those false teeth and the polyester wig and the padded bra and all that makeup, there lies a very sincere person.
Oh, thank you, Lance.
I think.
Don't encourage your father.
Christine, I just came back from the doctor's, and he tells me I have the body of a 17-year-old.
Well, give it back, Ross. You're getting it all wrinkled.
Listen, you guys, when I said before that I wanted you to start using your feet in this game, to run, to scramble, I didn't mean for you to run off the field and scramble out of the stadium.
But, Coach, what else are we supposed to do with our feet?
Kick the ball! This is soccer!
What is it? Oh, it's Ben. Yeah, what's the problem, kid?
Well, remember that new leg you sewed on?
New leg? Oh, yes.
Well, you sewed it on backwards.
and I'm kind of getting tired of walking around in circles.
Oh, yes. Well, I meant to explain that, Ben. You see, when we performed that operation, we only had left legs in stock. So I had to sew our left leg on instead, but I had to sew it on backwards so that it'd fit right.
But what can I do?
I don't know. Does Michael Jackson maybe need stand in for those spins? I bet it'd be $50 for the visit.
Okay, doesn't it just make you gag, Karen, that there are thousands of ugly little parasites that are completely dependent on our bodies for their very survival?
Oh, come on, Christine. That's no way to talk about our country's politicians.
Oh, Alistair, I want you to copy out pages 403 through 896,781.
That's not fair, sir. I shouldn't be in detention anyway. It's not my fault the teacher tripped over my foot.
You're right, Alistair.
Thank you.
And wait a minute. Look, if you can arrange to have your foot stay here in detention, then the rest of you may go. Otherwise, copy the pages.
I don't think I can.
Hello.
Hey, Mom, get this, a house call.
No.
Oh, can I help you?
We wondered if you'd be interested in donating your body to science.
No, I don't think so.
No, wait a minute. Your eyes, your heart, all your organs will go on living in different people. And they need the parts desperately.
Oh, yes, that's right. And other parts of your body, like your skeleton, well, it will go to a school where future scientists and doctors will study it.
Mm-hmm. You'll be helping hundreds of different people. Come on. Oh, by the way, we also give you $500.
$500?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, think of all the people I'd be helping. Yeah,
right.
Sure, I'll sign
that. Very good. Thank you. Okay, let's get her out of here.
Right. Oh, no, wait a second. You're supposed to wait until after I'm dead to take all the parts?
No, that's the $25 check.
No.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
Didn't you forget to do something this morning?
No, I don't think so.
I mean, didn't you forget to shave?
Oh, no, I've decided to stop shaving for a while. Going to grow a beard.
Oh, good. Wait till I tell my mom that I'm going to stop shaving and grow a beard. She's been bugging me to shave for ages.
Christine, no. You don't shave. You can't grow a beard.
Yes, I can. See?
Oh, my.
Good.
You know what, Lisa?
What?
This chicken reminds me of my initiation into my college for fraternity.
Why?
Well, because to get into the fraternity, you had to eat a chicken breast.
Dad, what kind of dumb initiation ceremony is that? Anybody can eat a chicken.
No. It wasn't easy as all that. You know, the feathers, they'd get tickled your throat and they'd get stuck down there. And before you were finished, the chicken would have your eyes almost pecked out.
Lisa, dear, you've got to learn to stop encouraging your father, especially at the supper table.
Okay. Oh, wow, what a set of headlights, man.
Let me see.
Alistair, that's a car.
Yeah, I know, eh? What a set of headlights.
Oh, the bumpers are...
Oh, Alistair, I've got some bad news for you. That heart is going to have to go.
Doc, you just installed a new heart 9 months ago. The warranty hasn't even run out.
Uh-oh.
And I've been exercising constantly. I jog 10 miles every day.
10 miles every day? Ah, let me see. That's 9 months ago. Whew. What a relief.
You mean you're not going to have to take out my heart?
No. It's a relief that you did all that running. You see, you still have some time left on your warranty, but the mileage has run out. You're going to have to pay for those repairs yourself. Hop to it. Snap it up. Hurry up. Excuse me.
Mom, what is that?
I've got to measure you guys for the perfect body for that commercial.
Sure.
Karen, Dad, let me see.
You want to do me again? I'll hold my breath.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Wait a second.
Well, you forgot to measure me.
Oh, yeah. Of course, I'm going to. I just have to go and get a larger tape measure.
Get it?
Hey, Ben.
Yeah, Lisa?
What do you call an organ bank made up of spare body parts from your family?
What?
A junkyard.
Well, in your case, Lisa, they call a place where your body parts a fat barn.
A fat barn.
That's funny.
You too.
Karen.
Yeah, Allison.
Did you know that Eunice is going to be the first ever recipient of a wart transplant?
What happened?
Well, they performed the operation, but the wart rejected her.
What? Oh, Christine.
What? Oh, how many body parts does it take to screw in a light bulb? How many?
No, don't you know? Because I really want to know. This is just general knowledge. It's not a joke.
She really wants to know. Come on, Lisa, use your head.
My head.
Now there, don't put it on your ankle.
Okay, so that's my head, my hands. Let's count from 5 or 6.
Wow, sir.
Yevon?
No, I think your belt's upside down.
And why is that?
Because your feet smell and your nose runs.
Come on, Ben. I'm just 100 years old.
Yeah, but in your case, Alistair, it's as true today as when it was first told.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah?
Do you know that new kid just moved in that day?
So?
Well, on the way home from school, he gave me the finger, and I'm not sure if it went too far.
What do you mean, went too far? If that kid gave you the finger, he deserved what he got.
But, Dad, it was me who got the finger. I'm not sure what I can do with that.
Oh, those stupid puercos.
Puercos?
Pigs.
Oh.
How could they do this to me?
Why? What's wrong with the firing squad today?
Well, you know what they did?
What?
They gave the finger to El Presidente.
Oh, that sounds pretty serious.
Oh, believe me, it was. It was their trigger fingers. No, he won't give them back.
You mean I get to go free?
No, not exactly, no. What we do is we postpone your execution. Let me see. Friday at 3.
Oh, no, I have a hair appointment on Friday.
Saturday at 11.
No, Saturday I go to my manicurist in the morning and I'm...
Yes, yes. What do you want? Oh, I see. You want to play Dragon's Breath.
Yeah, only we can't find the place to put the quarters in.
Because there is no slot.
I don't like the sound of this. Well, so how do you play?
Well, listen, you kids have been coming in here now for weeks and saying that you'd give your right arms to be able to play this game. Well, I made an arrangement with the transplant hospital, and I take them over some arms and...
Young man! What on earth are you doing?
See, miss, I was just checking out this book on childhood development and comparing it with myself to see how I was doing.
Well, not in the library! Now, put your gloves back on! This minute!
Hey! Attention, please. Any of you kids ever been in a car accident?
Oh, I have.
Oh. So what happened to your face, Ben? Seriously, really, all I want to know is, can any of you kids make the sound of squealing tires?
Why?
It's for that commercial. The client wants to make sure that whoever he selects has an empathy for his product.
Aw, Ross, come on. What is this mystery product?
I am not free to divulge that information, so forget it. Now, how about that being able to screech?
Well, the rest of us just might as well give up now. I mean, the best screecher there is, and I know of, is Lisa Ruddy.
Yeah,
you're right.
Sarah! Oh, okay, just shut your little mouth before I come over there and pound it at you.
Valerie, what are you doing with that poor cat? What's it got now?
Oh, well, the cat's got Lisa's tongue, dear.
Lisa's tongue? Then why are you trying to get it back?
We may have a point there.
Hold it, Gillis. Aren't you supposed to be in biology class
right now?
But I am, sir, or at least part of me is.
What are you talking about?
Well, you see, sir, last year I had an operation. I had my appendix taken out, and I donated it to the biology department. Now, and they keep it in a pickle jar 24 hours a day. So I figured that if part of me was in there 24 hours a day, then the rest of me didn't need to be in there for just one period.
Well, you thought wrong.
Karen, did you have to barf with school today?
What was Barth doing at school?
Well, see, we're dissecting frogs in biology, and I think Barth was there to pick up the leftovers. What do you think in the burgers?
I heard that.
Yes, very tricky, those Argentinians. Now, Gillis, are you picking your nose?
No, sir, I'm just doing what the principal told us to do.
Wait a minute. You telling me the principal told you to pick your nose?
No, he just told us to keep our hairs brushed.
I know I'm going to regret asking this, but what's brushing your hair got to do with picking your nose?
Well, I'm not picking my nose. I'm just brushing my nasal hairs.
Something up there, though.
Oh.
Ross is being very secretive about this perfect body stuff.
I know. All he does is walk around with that clipboard, making little notes every time he sees one of us. It makes me really nervous.
Yeah, me too. But you know what even makes me more nervous?
What?
Well, we're nearing the end of the show, and no one's had water dumped on them yet.
You can rest easy now.
So, Shriner, it's finally here. This is your day of release.
Really? Oh, boy, finally, blue skies, barbecue burgers, girls!
Except for one thing, we lost the key.
Oh, I knew there had to be a hack somewhere.
However, we gotta go by the rules. Yes, we have got to release you. We've got to turn you free.
Oh, I see that. You're gonna have to cut the shackles off my wrist, right?
Not quite, not exactly. We're gonna cut your wrists off the shackles. Yeah, come on, listen, wait a minute. You don't want us to ruin a perfect pair of shackles, do you? Besides, we might find a key. Now, hold still. Hey.
Come on, you guys, here it is. The final verdict on who is going to play that part in the commercial. First off, it was not a boy.
Wait a minute, it wasn't a boy? I was perfect for the part.
No, not in this case, Alistair. Too thin.
Yeah, I told you. And we know it's not me, so it's got to be either...
That's right. Are you ready? The winner is... Lisa Ruddy! Oh, boy.
Ross.
Congratulations.
No. Exactly what is this commercial for?
Relax. I was going to tell you. You see, they want someone to play the part of the Michelin Man's daughter, and you got the perfect body.
Can't Do That on Television has been a Foot in the Mouth production.
Lisa, how'd it go?
Yeah, you're gonna make lots of money, friend?
No, I just the mall part. I was sort of like a roll-on.
A roll-on?
Oh, yeah, you know, like a walk-on, except they stuck me to a tire and rolled me on.
Listen, Lisa, look on the bright side. You may not be the perfect hand, but you're a perfect radial.